Well, hundreds of fashion-savvy shoppers in Melbourne have camped out overnight for the long-awaited opening of the latest big-name fashion import. Hot on the heels of Zara, Topshop has launched its first Australian store. And our reporter Hermione Kitson is at the store where the doors opened just over an hour ago. Good morning, Hermione. Now, of course, we all love hitting the shops, but some shoppers went to extraordinary lengths to be the first through the doors.
Absolutely, Tash. Some of the hundreds of shoppers down here in line this morning actually set up camp at 6 o'clock last night. So you can imagine just how excited they were when the doors finally opened just over an hour ago, as you mentioned. The UK Fashion House has about 400 stores around the world, but this is Australia's first. Another one will open in Sydney next August. The fashion-forward but very affordable brand has a very similar business model to that of Spanish retail giant Zara, which of course has seen some huge success since it opened down under just a few months ago. And gauging from the crowds down here today, it's going to prove just as popular Topshop is.
Yeah, I had a good sleep.
Yeah, there was a launch party last night and all the people, the caterers, were giving us hors d'oeuvres.
There's Topshop water.
It is very exciting after waiting, I think, like 10 hours at night. So.
And Tamani, I understand this opening comes as another retailer is forced to close its doors.
That's right, Tash. Menswear company Fletcher Jones is on the brink of administration, throwing into question its 45 stores around the country. It, of course, follows the closure of many other retailers this year, one of which being Borders. Ironically, its Chapel Street store used to be here, now where Topshop is. Retail experts really hope that the buzz around this new store will boost a struggling industry.
It's obviously a new concept, and for the consumer, I'm sure it's going to attract a lot of people to Melbourne and a lot of visitors, probably even from interstate.
So I guess only time will tell, Tash, as to whether or not this new fashion house, the buzz around it, will keep shoppers spending well past Christmas.
All right, our reporter Hermione Kitson joining us there from Melbourne. Thank you.